Hour, starring Honey and Sis, with their special guests, Tom Bosley, Connie Stevens, the Sylvers, and Yogi Bear, with Rudy Vega and his Vitamin.
We all know the handful of superstars in the entertainment business, but there are only two truly superstars.
Two sisters whose records have all America dancing, whose television show has created a panic at the other two networks.
Ladies and gentlemen, the stars of the Hanna-Barbera Happy Hour, Honey and Sis.
We love those girls.
In the way.
Well, I don't like you calling me foolish.
But you are, my dear.
But I...
And I love you for it. I've thought about your being shy, and I have the answer. A trance.
Oh, I don't want to go into a trance. It's scary.
There's nothing to worry about. I'll stay right here, honest.
What do you know about trances?
What's there to know? Just look into my eyes.
Oh, I don't know.
If you don't trust your older sister, then we have no relationship at all.
Oh, all right.
Close your eyes. Are they closed?
Yes.
You sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You are falling asleep.
I am falling asleep.
Could I have a drink of water?
No!
When I snap my finger, you will step outside your own silly personality and become the radiant superstar known as Honey. Do you understand?
Yes, Master.
Wait! Who are you?
I am a superstar.
Working perfectly.
And I'd like to give you some unasked for but loving advice. First, your figure.
What's wrong with my figure?
Oh, nothing, if you dig pipe cleaners.
Hold on there!
And your voice. It's like fingernails scraping on a blackboard.
Just a second!
And you have all the charm of a pair of old sweat socks.
Stop this, sis!
Who sis? I'm Honey, can't you tell?
Oh, dear. I think I like me better on me than on her. Please, snap out of it.
Snap out of what? Oh, you certainly are a silly goose.
But...
And I love you for it.
I've created a monster.
Ladies and gentlemen, Connie Stevens. I've sung with good bands, bad bands, sweet bands, sad bands, bands from coast to coast. But Rudy, you and your vital man turn me on, knock me out, light my fire. Without a doubt, it's true. Sweet of you, the pure of you, the eyes, the arms, the mouth of you, the east, west, north, and the south of you. I'd love to gain. Wanna dance with me, baby?
you play, you blow me away. You're off the wall and I love all of you.
I'm glad you liked it.
Like it? I loved your number. Just loved it. It was so close.
What does that mean?
Well, I took the liberty of making some notes at the top.
Oh, no, honey. Connie, I thought it was just absolutely perfect.
Maybe for the gong show. Everyone wants to improve. I'm sure a big star like Connie is no different, right?
Can we talk about something else?
Don't give up. I can tell you're a very talented performer. It takes one to know what.
It so happens that I do that number better than anybody else.
That's true. That is true. No one really does it well. It could be your number, a real boost for your career.
Is she really your sister?
Oh, she doesn't mean anything by it.
What? If you don't want my help.
Let me struggle along without it, please.
It's a pity. So much potential going to waste.
Oh, dear. Connie, I'm sorry if she offended you.
Oh, that's all right. In show business, I've met all kinds. At least I thought I had until she came along.
Well, she's really not as tough as she comes off.
You mean underneath all this insensitive exterior, there's a soft, warm person.
Well, gee, I hope so.
I know you're sisters. But how did a sweet kid like you get hooked up with her?
It's a fascinating tale. Three movie studios are fighting over the story, you know.
Yeah, I can see it now. You take it. No, you take it.
Droll. It was only a year ago when we went to see this very important record producer.
Oh, the fabulous honey in my humble office. Chip it and stone it. This isn't showbiz history. Do you know that your composites don't do you justice? Listen, you'll have to excuse me. I just came from jogging in Beverly Hills.
Oh, you live in Beverly Hills?
No, no. I just keep a house there just to change clothes. Well, let's get down to business. Do you know that you're driving me crazy?
What do I do?
Nothing. Do something and I'll go berserk. All right, now let me put it right out there for you. You see, I not only want to produce your records, I want to produce your entire life. It's a 24-hour-a-day job with me, and from now on, your life is my life.
How about your other clients?
This goes no further than this office. Can she be trusted?
She's my sister.
Doesn't mean a thing. I got a father, I wouldn't turn my back on
her. Isn't Barbara one of your clients?
Well, Barbara's all right if you like that sort of thing. Cher is fine in spots. Liza has her moments, but honey, you put them all away.
Well, that's what I've always thought.
How right you were. Now, we're going to start off with a great big PR hype, you see? 60 cities, 5-page spread in People's Magazine, a Playboy interview, billboards on Sunset Boulevard, and then you're going to do your first concert, SRO, in Yankee Stadium, and then...
What?
The big tie. An international closed-circuit TV show. We'll reunite the Beatles to back you up. Hello. Yeah, get me Ringo, Paul, John, and the other one.
Well, it sounds right to us.
Hold that call. Us? What us?
Sis and me.
Can she sing, too?
She tries.
Oh, I can't use her. Look at her.
Sorry, Keith, it's either both of us or it's no go.
Oh, but honey, think what you're doing. You're throwing away your big chance at the brass ring.
Sorry, Keith, it's out of the question.
Think what you're saying.
My mind's made up.
You're not only fantastically talented, sensationally beautiful, and irresistibly charming, but you're more than that. You're noble.
Yeah, yeah. I know.
And everyone knows the rest.
Not everyone.
Oh, gee, now, I don't remember it happening quite that way.
I'm not surprised.
Well, I may have left out one or two unimportant details.
Well, now, I think it was really more than just one or two details. I mean,
get lost. Yeah, we're recording tomorrow. Be there at 5 a.m. Why? Because no one will bother us at that hour in the Penny Arcade. Well, what do you want?
Excuse us. We wanted to...
Hold it. Important call. Hello? Yeah? What's that? On whole wheat, huh? You got it. Salami? Sure. With ham? That's new. Yeah. A little lettuce. Mustard. And ketchup. Little sprouts? Fine. Fine. Of course it's good. Hmm? What? Oh, you want the deluxe? You got it. Right. Be there in 15 minutes. Call again. You still here?
We were wondering if we could audition for you.
All right, let's see you make a BLT and hold a mail.
Oh, well, see, we're not cooks. We sing. We're singers.
In that case, take off. Listen, don't let this call interrupt you. Feel free to leave while I'm talking. Hello? What do you know about avocados? Black is a natural color. They turn green when they get too old. You still here?
I don't like your attitude, Mr. Glick.
Well, then why don't you try the pizza joint next door? His attitude is great.
I think you're very rude.
Well, that doesn't ruin my day.
And, you know, we're not even going to be treated this way.
Yellow.
You mean? I came here to audition, and I'm going to audition.
Life the chorus.
That voice. Where is it coming from?
Misty watercolor memory.
You know, I got a gut feeling you can make it.
Wait till you hear me.
You know, Mr. Glick, I don't think that you're the producer for us.
Now, wait, don't be too hasty.
Sorry. Come on, let's go, honey.
Oh, we could make a big killing together.
Thank you, but no thank you.
Well, okay. Maybe you're right. But when you get to be big stars, don't forget me because I got just what you need.
For our career?
No, for your lunch. Hey. I got tuna salad. I also carry cream cheese and pimento. Avocado, turkey, BLT, egg salad, and lettuce.
For the rest of the happy hour, you'll be doing yourself a big favor.
Yeah, so why not be good to yourself?
Cute you are.
Well...
Honey, you're embarrassing, Foster.
Nonsense. Wow! Cute! Sis, have you ever seen such award-winning cuteness?
Oh, Foster, you'll just have to excuse her.
Oh, that's okay. That's okay.
Foster. Oh, wow! Are you cute?
Honey, will you cut that out?
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Didn't you ever feel like going out on your own?
No, they're my family.
So?
Well, would you break up with Sis?
Well, it would take something fantastic.
Like what?
Like you!
Monster, maybe you'd better do your song with the Sylvers. There's safety in numbers.
Okay, see you, Sis.
Sis, when I want your help, I will ask for it. Wow! That is so
charm.
Say the word and I dance. I'll go on.
Not now, Yogi.
But my group is all set.
Honey, I'd like to see them.
They're not ready for the big time. They're not even ready for the small time. Yeah.
Oh, sweetheart, could I see you for just a minute, please?
Of course, Daddy dear. Just as soon as I fix this poor little baby birdie's wing. There! You can die again!
Listen, my calculator just broke down while I was doing my federal income taxes, and I was wondering, would you mind running down to the store and getting...
Oh, no need for that, Daddy dear.
Oh, but you see, I have to add this whole column.
May
of
I, Daddy dear?
Huh?
6,577.
Oh, gosh, are you wonderful?
And you are wonderful too, Daddy dear.
I am?
Of course. How else could you have such a wonderful daughter?
Yeah, well, I guess I'll just finish these taxes later.
Oh, you don't have to, Daddy dear.
You mean?
I did them this morning before breakfast.
Why didn't you tell me?
Oh, I didn't want you to think I was taking over. I know how much pride you have.
Well, I still have my state taxes to those two.
I wanted to get it out of the way. I have a very busy afternoon. I have to go to singing lessons, ballet lessons, and violin lessons.
Well, I didn't know you took all those.
Oh, I don't take them. I give them.
Oh. Hello. Hi, Chief. Well, about the newspaper. Now, I think maybe that we should put the story about the fireman's strike on page four. Yeah. And the one about the kid that fell into the well, we can put that on page three. And then maybe that, the new medical Chief, can I call you right back? There. No?
Oh, Daddy dear, if you think it should be done that way, it's perfectly all right.
Good.
We're all in kind of make the dance.
Sweetheart, we have to have a little talk. Now, look, I am a mature man.
That's right, Daddy dear.
And I have lived a long time, long, much longer than you have.
Of course, Daddy dear.
And I'm no dope.
Now you're pushing it.
I wonder who that can be.
Probably the girl from next door with some terrible problem.
Well, how would you know? Forget it.
Oh, Jesus, Thomas, can you help me?
Of course, little girl from next door. Let's hear your terrible problem.
Oh, how did you know?
Well, let's just say I know, huh?
My mommy and my daddy want to take a vacation this year, but we can't afford it.
If they can't afford it, well, then maybe you could just save up for next year, huh? You could get yourself a part-time job, huh?
Of course my daddy dear can help you. He'll tell your father to refinance the house, use his car as collateral, consolidate his debts, and put up his stocks as surety for a bank loan.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
Oh, boy! We'll have a vacation this year after all! Oh, wow! You're wonderful! Oh,
thanks.
Who's talking to you?
Now look, sweetheart. I have had just about enough.
Let's talk after you answer the phone.
It isn't ringing.
It will.
Hello? Oh, yes, Chief. What's that? Well, of course I can make a decision for myself. But you can't fire me. I've given 20 years to that newspaper. Hello? Oh. He hung up. Now you see what you've done to me, huh? I'm all washed up because I can't think for myself anymore. Now we're both gonna starve.
Oh, Daddy dear, that's silly. We'll both be fine.
What? What? You were right. We won't starve. Chief, you want someone for the job of editor of the entire newspaper?
Isn't that wonderful?
It's for you.
Wow. Towel, yeah.
Stick around for the second half of the Hanna
Barbera Happy Hour and treat yourself to a wonderful time.
The Hanna-Barbera Happy Hour will be right back.
Starring Honey and what's her name?
Oh, really?
No. Someone will be along in a moment.
But we've been here for 15 minutes. I'm getting all wrinkly.
Oh, stop complaining. Can't you get it that in the truth tab you're supposed to relax and let all your problems just come to the surface?
What is so dumb sitting here in a bathing suit?
Why?
Whoever saw a prune wearing a bikini?
That's a problem worth talking about.
Oh, talk to a prune about it.
I mean your vanity. You're always so worried about the way you look.
I am not. I know just how I look.
That's another problem.
Oh, no. Somebody's coming.
Good. Maybe I can talk to her about what troubles me.
Which is?
I'm not appreciated. Sometimes I feel a concern I show about you simply wasted.
Oh, it's not wasted. It's recycled and recycled and recycled.
Hello. Somebody told me I could come here and talk about my problems.
What could be bothering her? She's so pretty.
Looks have nothing to do with it. I should know. I think I know what your problem is.
Really?
Fear of water.
It's so hard to live with. Every time I dive off the high board, I feel like I'm going to drown.
Why's that?
Because I don't know how to swim.
Then why do you dive into the water?
I know how to dive.
That's fascinating. How about my problem, you see?
Even swimming lessons don't help.
You had lessons?
Yeah, in school. But we didn't have a pool. So we had to lie on these gym mats and practice our strokes.
Well, if you know all the strokes...
When I tried it in a pool, it didn't work. It was terrible. The gym mat kept sinking.
Well, my problem is that people don't seem to appreciate these
I'm also afraid of heights.
Swell. Oh, look, it seems to me that if people would understand...
Oh, I'm terrified of flying in an airplane, too.
Oh, a lot of people are.
And I'm a wreck before I skydive.
You're afraid of heights and you skydive?
Yeah, it's the fastest way down.
Okay, it's my turn. I want to talk about the fact that I am not a...
I'm also scared of crowds.
Well, can't you avoid them?
If you go to Times Square on New Year's Eve, how are you going to avoid a crowd?
Why do you go there?
I should stay home and miss all the fun?
You know something... Your problems bore me. They're boring. Boring, boring.
Well, I'm not too thrilled about them either.
Well, why do you test yourself all the time?
Because I believe in conquering one's fears.
Well, gee, maybe you shouldn't try so hard.
Nonsense. Why don't you take off that silly tire and see what happens?
Oh, you think I should?
Yeah, take it off. Go ahead.
Oh, gee, I didn't think that would happen.
Oh, I did. Now look, about my problem.
I'm coming.
Hey, B complex, what was that? That's not how we rehearsed it. Hey, fireman, don't butt in. Who asked for the discussion? Let's do it like we rehearsed it. Rudy, don't tolerate no mutiny.
Hey,
Hey, I am about to do you a big favor.
You leaving town?
No, I'm nursing with the band. Thanks a bunch.
Yeah, okay. You got your charts?
Charts? The only one I have is a chart of Jellystone Park.
Well, that's cool. We can play it.
How about that up tune? Like,
Whoa. Oh, I got a great idea. How would you like an echo effect?
Yeah, that sounds good. How do we do that?
See that mountain peak?
Yep.
Well, climb up there and sing away.
Yeah, but that's a two-day hike.
So start now.
Yeah, you know more about music than I do, even though I'm smarter than the average bear. Yeah, sweet Adeline, sweet Adeline.
Get it!
And now for the part of the show you all have been waiting for. And look, I'd like to take time to thank you for your patience as well as your good taste. I select a phone number at random, call the fortunate person and sing one of my songs that he or she loves the best. Here goes. This is someone's lucky day. I won't tell what the phone number is because if he or she isn't home, they'll kill themselves. Okay. Mm-hmm. 4, 7. 3, 3, 2, 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, 4.
Hello, Maxie. Oh, my, glad you called. I want to put $1,000 on Busy Buddy in the fourth.
Hello. Is this Mr. Ted Mooney of Troy, New York? This is Honey.
Maxie, you don't have to talk in code. My phone isn't tapped.
And I selected you out of the millions of phone owners to sing your favorite song. Imagine.
Listen, Maxie, I know you got a weird sense of humor, and sometimes it's even funny, but the race is about to start.
Oh, where do you be, Mr. Ted Mooney of Troy, New York?
This isn't Maxie, isn't it?
How about Hold Me, But Don't Fold Me? Or perhaps America the Beautiful, Done Disco?
Listen, yo, get off the line. Maxie's gonna call me. I got my life savings in a sure thing in a fourth race.
Oh, I'm so excited. Can't decide, Mr. Ted Mooney of Troy, New York? Well, look, let me pick one for you.
It's a 50-to-1 long shot. I'll be rich. Get on the phone.
So here goes Colorado Sunshine.
Hey, not now. The network wants to go to a commercial.
Well, if the network, we'll just have to wait. Hit it!
I'm heading down to
you like it, Mr. Ted Mooney of Troy, New York?
Do you know what the race? Busy Buddy at 50-to-1. I could have made a fortune.
Oh, he's all choked up. Well, goodbye for now.
Why hang up? You'll love hearing me die. You listening?
Are you...
I'm so glad I could bring just a little bit of happiness into a drab life of someone. And next week, who knows, the lucky person could be you!
Oh, sis, you're such a goof. You're dumb. You're dumb.
chitty, come, come, come. Oh, like a tang, tang, tang. Oh. Join me, broccoli for the troops.
No, thanks. Rudy, last night I did such a drippy thing. I had a date, and when the fellow tried to kiss me goodnight, I said, it's been a lovely evening.
Please, don't ruin it.
How do you know?
I hear that a lot.
But I really wanted to kiss him.
So?
I'm afraid that I don't know how to kiss.
Well, it takes practice.
Really?
Sure. Follow me. First, you close your eyes.
Okay.
Are they closed?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good. All right. Then you let your lips do the walking. And when you open your eyes, you'll be in heaven.
How right you are!
Oops. Now hear this. Left follows right. Right follows left. Left, right, left, right.
Honey, look, it really wasn't what it looked like. He was just practicing.
I know. For me.
For you?
Of course. Can't you see he's crazy about me?
He can. Like, holy moly!
Hey, Rudolph, there he is. Eat your heart out. Hey!
I've decided I'm going to put a new bit in the show that's really wonderful and different.
Am I in it?
I said wonderful. A ventriloquist sketch.
Oh, boy, I love ventriloquists. Who's going to be on?
Me. I'm going to do the bit.
Well, I never knew you could be.
Don't finish that sentence. You'll just sound foolish. Ta-da! Yes. This is Jimmy. Jimmy, say hello to Sis.
Hello, Chubby.
Good. Well, I don't know.
Jimmy, tell me, how do you like my dress?
I think it's beautiful, but then you're beautiful, honey.
How about that?
I can see your lips moving.
Well, if you're going to get that close, of course. But the audience won't see.
Jimmy,
what do you think about my singing? I think you're the best singer there is, bar none. Isn't that fun?
Honey, in most ventriloquist acts, the fun comes from the dummy giving the zingers, not the compliment.
Well, of course, Jimmy will give zingers.
Really?
To you.
Oh, honey, you'll never change. And I love you for it. Good night.
Now the song that made Honey and Sis famous, and vice versa.
This time is my happy hour. This hour with you. There's never enough time to say the things we want to say, to do the things we want to do. Time flies. Time flies so fast. Baby, 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 before this hour is past, let's make it last. This time is my happy hour. These moments you time to dance the way we want to dance, to sing the songs we want to sing. Time flies and it's time you were leaving. Next time you're free.
Special thanks to Phil Leeds. Your check is in the mail.